one thing to consider before going on your first distance race or for your first offshore excursion is what to do with weight on the boat. Here on this particular boat, you can see we have a lot of stuff in this aft hatch or aft companionway, tool bags, dock lines, sail covers. This is not a good spot for this stuff. What we want to do is consolidate all of our weight in the interior of the boat, low and centered. And as your crew arrives, you want to remind them of that as well. Thinking that, hey, the wind is our power, the wind is our engine, it's what moves this boat through the water. We want to make sure we're as well prepared as possible to go distance racing today. And we'll go down below and take a look at that and how we're being efficient in putting our weight low and centered in the interior of the boat. All right, today we're down below on this J122 getting ready to go for our first distance race. And we're taking a little extra time, a little extra effort to make sure that our boat is as light and as efficient as possible. We've gone through the interior. We've looked into refrigerator or into your chili bin cooler. We've made sure we don't have any extra beverages or anything like that. We've gone through all of our drawers, all of the little spots in a boat where extra things can hide, and we've eliminated all of that weight. As you can see, we have the interior very thin. We've even removed our cushions because we're anticipating a rainy ride later on this afternoon and evening. When the crew arrives, we'll ask them to place their crew bags here in a central location where the weight is centralized, as I mentioned, and low. Once we leave the dock, we'll take our sails and we'll put them right on the interior floor. So there again, the weight is low and centralized in the interior of our boat. Some other things you can look for is, do you have any extra pots and pans that you don't need? Do you have any extra gear such as foul weather gear, blankets, pillows that you don't need? What you can do to maximize your boat, that knowing that the wind is your power, is your engine, and you're trying to do everything you can, that when the winds are light, that you're constantly moving, that you're constantly doing everything you can to squeak that little bit of boat speed out so that you're very efficient in your distance race. Here on our backstay, we've developed a scale. We've taken a simple piece of batten stock and attached it to our hydraulic cylinder so that we have a static point. Then our backstay ram, and that is our dynamic point. What this scale allows us to do is, as conditions change, wind speeds change, sea states change, or crews change, be it that we know we're all overnight and we have some crew down below sleeping, they come up perhaps in the wee morning hours and the other team goes down below, we can say, hey, we've been successful running at the red mark or the green mark, or perhaps you don't have different colored tapes and you just have a numbered scale, a 1, a 2, a 3. And you can say, previously when the wind was at 12 knots, we were at number 3 or green. Now as the wind has increased to 18 knots, we've gone all the way down to red, or perhaps say the number 1. And as I said previously, this is an excellent way that you can remember settings as your crews change on a distance race or as the winds increase or decrease. Another place that you can put some type of a scale to replicate settings is here on our deck, just aft of our jammers for our halyards. You see we have a numbered scale from 1 to 10 behind a jib halyard and a spinnaker halyard. This there again allows us to replicate halyard settings for our head sail or our spinnaker. You will have some type of a mark on your halyard, and as that mark slides from say 3 to 4 to 5 to 6, you know that you've changed your halyard tension. Some of the benefits of this are when you're doing head sail changes in a distance race, be it from a light air sail to a heavy air sail, you would think your halyard mark would change. Also, when you're switching teams or crews, perhaps you have 3 people on deck that are now going down below to sleep, the next group's coming up, you're going to want to let them know, hey, here's where our halyard mark is. If you switch to a different sail, here's where your halyard mark might go. This is another excellent way to keep consistency in your sail settings as you progress on your distance race. As we continue to get ready to go distance racing today, we're going to take some time to put a numbered scale next to our jib lead. As you can see, we have a numbered sticker that we will place on the deck right next to our jib lead. Say we place this numbered scale right in the middle of our track and our jib lead. The benefits of this is, as we change sails or lead settings, or as we even change crews on our boat from say a night watch to a day watch, we can say we've been very fast or very successful running this particular sail with our jib lead at number 10 or 9. Perhaps as the winds change or we change sailing angles, we need to move our lead forward to number 7 or 6 or even 5. This process, having this scale here, allows you to pass that information on to crews as you change watches in a distance race, or also to remember as you change settings between sails where your jib lead was previously. This is a great way to replicate what you know is fast on your particular boat and to make sure you're always fast as you continue distance racing today. One tip we wanted to pass on to everyone today is bow lacing. Some of the benefits of bow lacing are, as you can see, we've started our bow lacing on our lifelines forward of our shrouds all the way to our bow pulpit. What this helps do is keep sails on the boat, be it spinnakers, asymmetricals, head sails if we're doing any type of sail change. It also just adds a small safety net for our crew as if they're on the bow performing any type of maneuvers. Here on this particular boat, a J122, you can see the owner elected not to put any eye straps on his deck to run his bow lacing. What he's done is taken a piece of line or a bungee and attached it to the bottom of the stanchions and run it forward to his bow pulpit. This gives our bottom platform for our lacing. And as you can see, as I complete this process, I simply come down and continue to tie half hitches here on the bottom, run it up to the middle lifeline, and continue the process from the middle lifeline on up to the top line lifeline. Now, other ways of doing this is if you have eye straps or something, you may run your bottom through the eye strap, or if you want and you don't want to do this V panel, you can just run straight vertical lines every 12 to 18 inches. And as I said, this is a very nice way to have an additional type of safety net on the bow of your boat when you're doing any type of maneuvers forward with crew or with sails. The wind has moved aft on our boat. We have the mainsail out, we have our jibbies, and we're now reaching down the lake or down the ocean for our distance race. One thing to make our sail plan more efficient is moving our head sail to an outboard lead, and I'd like to demonstrate that for you today. So I'm gonna get the new sheet. And one thing we wanna show here on this outboard lead is we want to widen our sheeting angle. So we're gonna use a changing sheet here. This could be a spinnaker sheet or an extra jib sheet that you have with you. And we're going to go through our spinnaker lead. Taking it outside the lifelines. We're going to continue up towards the clew of the head sail, and we are going to go outside the shrouds. Now I have my outboard sheet affixed to the clew of my head sail. All right. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back again to the cockpit. And as we mentioned, we might have to find a spare winch that I can put this sheet on. I'm going to use a winch here in the pit. I'm now going to go on to my outboard sheet. One thing I think we want to demonstrate is you see now at the clew, I'm taking up on the new sheet, which is our outboard sheet, this red, white, and blue one. And now I can fully ease my original jib sheet. The benefit of this is, as you can see in our sail plan, now that we're in a reaching configuration, we've moved our sail plan further outboard as our angle of attack has gotten wider. An additional thing we can do to help maintain our head sail control is put some type of a lead system on this, just like if we were using our jib lead. What we're going to use here today is a snatch block and a tweaker line. All right. So two additional parts that we have for our outboard lead reaching configuration is a snatch block and another line with a snap shackle on it that can be our tweaker line. What we have on this boat is we have pad eyes here on the port side, one right here, and a second one up here by the shrouds. Another thing you might have on your boat is a continuous tow rail, or your boat might even have some type of an outboard lead already on the boat. Here today, we are going to put our snap shackle on the pad eye gonna run our tweaker line through the snap shackle. And then as you can see, I can take this shackle and attach it right onto the sheet. Now when I take up on this, this acts exactly like a jib lead. If you pull down, it's just like moving your jib lead forward or increasing the leech tension of your head sail. If you ease up, it's exactly like moving your jib lead aft or decreasing the tension on your leech. So today, the top of our sail is spilling or opening up, just like our top telltale might be luffing if we're sailing upwind. So we are going to increase some tension on our tweaker, helping close off the upper leech of our head sail. Thank you.